Hi, it's Dre Griggs with Obsidian Wisdom. Today we'll be answering the question, when should I get financial advice? Most people worry about money, so we created the Wisdometric framework to help people eradicate financial stress, generate a passive income, and build a prosperous retirement strategy. We are fiduciary advisors who combine comprehensive financial advice with retirement planning and generational wealth management. When you are determining when you should get financial advice, if you are Googling or asking maybe friends or family or just trying to maybe get ahead of the curve, most of the time you should get financial advice, it's going to depend. I will tell you my personal rule is you want to weigh two things. One is the impact of the financial decision that you're going to make. What I mean is the decision something small like I want to get a toy for maybe $15 or something like that? Or you're talking about getting a much larger toy for yourself that may cost thousands, if not tens or hundreds of thousands of dollars. Well, depending on the size of the financial investment that you're going to take an adventure with, then that would be something that you'll want to consider. The second thing is just really how much you know about the decision that you're going to make. If you are well-versed in it, then maybe you're very comfortable making that decision. If it's new to you or you're trekking on a different, maybe just something different, then getting financial advice may make a lot of sense to you. Generally, you'll weigh those two things. How much do I already know about it? What is the financial impact if I get it wrong? And then you'll go from there. More times than not, when you're looking whether I should get financial advice, you're normally going to be going through a life event of some kind. More times than not, though, the very beginning of it is going to be if maybe someone is tired of debt, then they're going to be saying, look, I need to figure out how to get out of this. And that's a common situation that most people find themselves in. 80% of Americans live paycheck to paycheck, and about, I believe it's like 65% of Americans are projected to retire broke. What I mean is they'll have $5,000 or less in their retirement account when they retire at the age of 65 on average. The second thing would be your whether you're getting married or divorced. Both of those are significant financial decisions. Even though we don't always think of those decisions like that, they actually have a financial impact. And it's one of those things where you do want to make sure you're going in eyes wide open with a plan on which accounts to combine, which accounts not to combine, which debts are we going to pay off in which order. The more information that you know ahead of time, the easier it will be. Finances is a very big decision when it comes to marriages and often can be one that can cause rifts in them. Also, you'll find that really how do we want to raise our kids is also one of those things that you commonly read are going to be rifts. Whether you're talking about religion, whether you're talking about the city and the community, you really want to be able to flesh out some of these goals. And if you sit with an advisor, then they're going to ask you the right questions. Meeting and getting financial advice is not always about finances. A lot of the time, it's just simply about goal setting, understanding where does you want to go and how can we figure out the most efficient way to get there. And then you decide how much does that goal cost? What are the ways that we can structure our finances to accomplish that goal? But it is always process driven. What is it that you are seeking to do? What is it that you want to accomplish? And then we will take the steps there together. The third thing would just be large purchases. We've sort of hinted that in the intro. I don't know what you want to spend your money on, but if you have a very large portion of it that you're going to allocate towards something, you know, maybe just based on percentage, if you're going to just invest based on dollars, then you can say, you know what, if maybe this is a dollar amount that I've never spent before, I'd love to talk to someone about it. But a lot of the times it varies depending on how much money you already have. So more times than not, when you decide if it's a large purchase, you're going to decide that based on the percentage of income. That percentage could be 5%, 10, 15. I mean, generally, right, your mortgage is your largest expense. And on average, that's about 30% of your income. So really, when you start getting into that five, definitely double digits. If you're over 10%, you should probably definitely talk to someone. The next thing would be as if you're starting a business. If you have plans to start a business or maybe you're looking to expand your business, either way, you would talking to a financial advisor, getting a professional's advice, then that could be something that could help you. They say about right 80% of businesses, depending on where the stats is that you're looking at, some as high as like 90% of businesses will fail in the first 5 years. And the number one reason that they fail is that they're not financially funded. And so if you did have the opportunity to meet with an advisor, then you could find yourself in that small percentage of businesses that find success because they have the plan to accomplish those goals. The fifth one will be the largest financial endeavor that you're going to go on, and that is going to be your retirement. Gone are the days of being able to work somewhere for 30 to 40 years, and then you get your pension and a golden watch, and you kind of ride off into the sunset. We're now at a point in time where less than 20% of companies even offer a pension. And for those that are 100% sure, a pension is just a guaranteed income for a certain number of time, whether that number is like 10 years or for the rest of your life. And then it varies because you could choose where it covers you and your spouse or versus just you, and you can, it really goes down. But generally speaking, a pension is just money that I get for a certain amount of time the rest of my life from the place I worked at. Now we don't have pensions. It's not a common thing. The majority of your finances are going to come from you. So you're not, we're even at a point now where we're even debating whether Social Security is going to be around. And so again, without Social Security, without your pension, two things that used to be the pillar of retirement back in the day, well, now you have to do the heavy lifting. Personal 401ks and investment plans are going to be the majority of most people's retirement plans. So you want to make sure that you have that covered. And speaking with a financial advisor is going to be critical because we're now at a place where people are working 30 to 40 years to then retire, which means not work, but yet generate an income for another 30 to 40 years, right? It's almost at a point where you're working as many years as you're going to be retired. And that requires a significant amount from you. And six, we have just growing your family. A lot of the time, there's never a perfect time to expand your family, but it doesn't mean that there is not a perfect time to start planning. If you are looking for opportunities to grow your family, expand your family, maybe move into a larger home, which would be a large purchase, or maybe funding the hospital bill and things like that, well, you're going to want to have a comprehensive plan. You need that financial advice to make sure that you can just focus on loving your kid. As a father of four myself, I know how important it is in our goals as parents to provide for our kids, do the best that we can, give them the wisdom that we have so that they're able to succeed in areas that we fell short. Well, there's also this idea where we're like, I really want to leave a legacy. Well, some of the legacy is going to be based on what we just talked about, which is your retirement planning. You can't leave a legacy if you don't have the ability to live off of your own income that you have in your retirement plan. Otherwise, your children will be funding your retirement, which is a reverse legacy, which means you pull it from them. But if you maybe as a parent wanted to fund your kids' college or education, or maybe you wanted to help fund the start of their business, all of these are things that will leave a legacy and will help your child. And you can kind of go from there as far as if I have the plan in place, is it the most tax efficient plan? Is it set in a way where it's easy for them to access? Did I give any rules for them to get the money? Is there, is there a trustee kind of a thing? Like, there really is a lot of avenues that you could plan out when it comes to having children. And then the last one, and it sort of teased it just a little bit, would be, hey, if you have an inheritance. If you gained an inheritance, or if you won the lottery, whether you won the lottery by the family that you were born into, or whether you won the lottery because you played lottery numbers, however it works out, you know that on average it takes 3 years for people to completely spend their lottery winnings, where millionaires go back to poverty, where professional athletes end up going back to poverty, where musicians and artists and entertainers. That there really comes down to a certain mindset that we all need to have. The mindset that we have has generated the life that we have today. And what that means is if we want to make a change in our life, then we have to make a change in our mindset. So how can we adjust our mindset? Well, You can do that either by, you know, reading lots of books and learning from different people who are living the life that you're trying to live, or you can have kind of that accountability partner where you put the plan together when you're kind of at your highest vibration, and then they help you stick to that plan. Oftentimes, if we don't really think exactly how long does this money need to last, what am I trying to accomplish with it, how can I make sure that I'm using it in the best way, or even maybe, you know, how can I invest it, how can I grow it, you know, how can I expand it? Well, before you know it, we'll end up spending it all and we'll be back where we're at. Whether that was, oh, I've always wanted to get rid of this debt's been bothering me. Well, there is an aspect where you're like, hey, peace of mind is definitely a good thing, but could we have maybe set up something where it's paid out over, you know, 3 years, and then you're able to invest a portion of the other money so that you're not just spending it all right away. You always want to pay yourself first. And the way I look at that is the same way you make your car payment. I think once you pay your car off, that you should continue making that same monthly payment just to yourself, whether you put that money in an investment account or into a business or rental properties, however you want to put the money. I do think that when you own the vehicle, that you should pay yourself. And a lot of the times we think, okay, I'm done paying the bank for, you know, this loan, this debt, and now I can put the money on something else. And you could, but I do think that it would be better for you to continue paying, but to pay yourself as the now owner of whatever it was that you were paying that loan back before. And so if that makes sense, there's just lots of options for you when it comes to answering that question, when should I get financial advice? But again, the two questions I would ask myself, the first one is, what is the financial impact of this decision if I was to get it wrong? And second is, you know, how much do I know about this particular issue? If you answer those two questions and it's financially significant and you're not really sure exactly what the goes into that decision, then I would say it would be important to get financial advice, because there's going to be two places that you get wisdom from. You either get wisdom from your own mistakes or you get wisdom from other people's mistakes. I would encourage you to get wisdom learning from others. What did other people go through? What was their mistakes? What were their lessons? And how could you apply that to your life so that you don't have the same ones? Right? I mean, at the end of the day, that's really what we're all trying to do just as parents, right? We're trying to teach our children from our mistakes so that they don't make the same ones. And it doesn't always work out that way. Believe me, I know. But it doesn't mean that that's not the most efficient way to operate. So if you have any additional questions, I am always here for you. There is a retirement planning that works training. It is free. Go to obsidianwisdom.com/training. There you can access a free video training. It's about 35 minutes. I give you the entire wisdom metric framework, and you can use that to start eradicating your financial debt, generating your passive income, and building a prosperous retirement strategy. Until next time, remember that wisdom is asking the right questions to allow yourself to get the right answer. Keep asking those questions, and you will keep getting those answers. Until next time, Wisdomites, continue blessings.